And he worked us very hard. He made us play very accurately. There's always a tuner up, making sure that every note was in tune, and do it again, and sit there for ages getting sounds. And it's a good, it was an interesting way of working. We've never really worked that way. We've obviously, when you make an album, you concentrate on everything you're doing, but he really was like the very fine, every fine detail he really works on. So it was a good experience, and I think he got, you know, he made us work hard, he made us play well. So it's probably helped a lot from that point of view. It was good, it was a good experience. He's a big man, he's very scary. And yeah, you're right, it's the first time we've ever worked outside England. And I just think because we could try it, the producer who we were using told us it's a very good studio, it's called A Village Recording, and it's basically a classic album, so we thought we'd try it, you know. We're just musicians, you just try and make the best music you can. So, you know, and also I think Gavin and Robin have girlfriends over there, so there was a bit of a, like, you know, that was their payoff. I was in London with mine, and then we switched and went to California, so it was interesting, it was a good experience.
Then Dave, also als kantisch, sang ihrer Geschwister zur Musik kommen.
I had an older brother and sister, and they gave me old punk records, Clash records, and Damned, and Sex Pistols, and eventually they gave me a guitar, and I used to sit there and go, you know, and it's the best music to learn, you know, it's the famous for having two finger chords, you know, so it was easy to learn. So I sort of even say that, not in front of the mirror. My bedroom is too small to have a mirror to stand in front of, but...
Maar ook houdt het push naar de jongen de anamnese.
I think you do listen to stuff, and I don't know that I necessarily get much inspiration from it. I think you listen to, you know, I listen to reggae, listen to dance music, listen to old Clash records. You know, I listen to everything, and I guess it does somewhere. It creeps, you know, once in a while something comes out of you. That, oh, that's something. You know, sort of, I guess it does influence you, but I've never specifically. You know, we've never specifically gone home and, right, we're all going to listen to old Velvet Underground records and come back and make a record. So not quite like that, but I'm sure that, you know, if you hear something, a great sound, you think, oh, that's good, and maybe you want to copy that sometimes.
Speed Kills war die erste Auskopplung vom Golden State Album. Leider soll das Single kurz nach dem Attentat auf dem 11. September auf den Markt kommen und hat dem noch ein bisschen an The People We Love umgedreht gehen.
It was the time to release a record for everybody, you know. I think other bands also suffered that. It wasn't the best time, and I think Speed Kills didn't seem very appropriate to that. And so it wasn't a big decision. I don't think we didn't have to change, we didn't change the music, you know, we didn't change the song, we just changed the title. So it wasn't that too, you know, just out of respect for people, it's not, you know, it seemed a bit inappropriate. So it wasn't really a problem. Also we had to change the album artwork as well. We had like a silhouette of a plane on the thing, and it didn't seem quite that seemed a bit unfortunate as well. So, you know, we did, but it wasn't, there was no pressure. I want you to remember.